Hello YouTube, my name is Rutger Steenbergen and in this video I'm going to demonstrate how to use TrackSpacer in PreSonus Studio One. TrackSpacer, I've inserted an instance of TrackSpacer on my baseline channel, it's right here. And it's the demo version, so click and continue demo evaluation. It's selected right now on the bass channel and I go to my kick channel and I'd like to sidechain the baseline with this TrackSpacer plugin. You can do so by using the sense channels and I've selected the kick channel and here sense channel and I can press on this little icon, this little arrow. Go to sidechain and then select the right channel, sidechain, baseline audio, inserts, track 3, TrackSpacer. And that's the one I want to be sidechained, the baseline channel. I can check if it works, the kick, gonna solo it, and the baseline, and now the TrackSpacer, and if it works well, you can see the baseline is sidechained with the TrackSpacer. Well, what's different from TrackSpacer than a normal sidechain compressor? TrackSpacer works with 32 bands of EQ and you have a lot more control of how much sidechain is applied. You can read more about it on the site of Waves Factory, but this is how to set this plugin up in PreSonus Studio One. You have two more knobs, low cut to avoid the low frequencies of being sidechained, and you can do so for the high cut frequencies as well, the high frequencies. And with this big knob you can decide the amount of sidechain EQing with the TrackSpacer plugin. So this is how to set it up. Put the instance of the TrackSpacer on your on the channel you want to be sidechained. And then decide to which channel it has to listen. In this case, the TrackSpacer is on the bass channel. The kick channel is the one who talks to the bass channel. So from the sidechain option, the arrow key sidechains, select the right channel right here. And right now, the TrackSpacer is listening to this kick channel. So this is how to set this up in Studio One.